Hello everyone and welcome back. Festivities have just gone by, so today I thought of compiling 4 easy breakfast recipes to make your mornings easier. The first is a high protein hung curd paneer sandwich. I keep some curd in a sieve overnight in the fridge and get this really nice and thick curd in the morning. Now to make the sandwich masala, I'll fine chop or grate all the available vegetables that is in my fridge and keep them ready. Now in order to add more protein, I'll also grate some paneer and this will make the filling very creamy and delicious. Now add all the spices mentioned on the screen along with all the chopped vegetables. Add salt and combine everything well. Instead of mayo or any store-bought dressing, make this instant creamy filling. Add the choice of your veggies and make healthy and delicious sandwiches for kids' lunchbox or even for yourself during those busy mornings. Layer the sandwich with chutney or ketchup and add the filling generously in the sandwich so that you get the juicy filling in every bite. Now I'll toast these sandwiches on tawa in the tempering of ghee, mustard seeds and some red chili powder. You can even add curry leaves and adjust the quantity of tempering as per your likings. Not sure about all, but I definitely did a lot of indulgence during festivities. So I guess these light and easy breakfast recipes will help me balance out that extra calories that I have gained. Toast them till they turn crispy and golden brown. And crunchy from outside, yet soft and creamy from inside, healthy protein-rich sandwiches gets ready in no time. The next quick to make everyday breakfast recipe, but with a twist, is my favorite Haryali Sabudana. For that, I'll first make the Haryali Masala. I'll grind some green chili, curry leaves, mint leaves, coriander leaves and ginger and make a coarse paste in a mixer grinder. Now, I'll chop half the potato into small size. Small size potatoes will cook quickly and will also look good as they will have the similar size of Sabudana. I'll also crush some roasted peanuts to add some crunchy texture to this Sabudana. So the trick for fluffy Sabudana is to wash it 3 to 4 times before soaking it in 1:1 ratio of water. This means for 1 cup of Sabudana, use 1 cup of water to soak it in. Overnight soaking gives better results and you get these non-sticky and fluffy pearls of Sabudana. Now into this Sabudana, add crushed peanuts, sugar, salt, freshly grated pepper and black salt and keep aside. In the kadai, I'll take some oil and crackle cumin seeds. Now add chopped potatoes and fry for 5 to 7 minutes. When the potatoes are half done, add peanuts and green masala and fry them also for 2 to 3 minutes. And in the end, add Sabudana mix and cook covered for 5 minutes. Once you'll try this Haryali twist, trust me, it will be hard to go back to normal Sabudana. The flavor of herbs tastes super amazing and makes ordinary Sabudana extraordinary. Add lemon juice to balance all flavors and delicious and quick to make Sabudana is ready to serve. The next recipe is another easy treat and a very healthy to begin your day with. It is moong dal paratha. I had pre-soaked some moong dal So now we'll make the moong dal mixture for the parathas. These parathas are best for kids' tiffin boxes and can be made in so many ways. For here, I'm using moong chilka. You can use moong sprouts or even yellow moong. So for the basic prep, I'll peel 5 to 6 garlic and 1 onion and put them in a chopper. Along with this, I'll add 1 inch ginger, coriander and curry leaves, as herbs add a lot of flavor and freshness, and a green chili. Now I'll add soaked pulses with cumin seeds and salt and fine chop everything. The first batch is ready and I'll make another quick batch. Now I'll add whole wheat flour into this mixture along with turmeric, red chili powder, garam masala powder and 2 to 3 teaspoon curd and knead a soft dough. Add the curd slowly to avoid making the dough too soggy. Just remember that onions will also release some water later, so add the curd gradually, because if at all the dough gets soggy, adding too much flour later will reduce the flavor from your parathas. Now, just like ordinary parathas, roll the parathas and toast them on tawa with the help of ghee. These parathas are a meal in itself. Someday when I'm pressed with time, I prefer to make them and enjoy them with chutney or curd. My kids love parathas and so I try to find different ways and means to make these parathas healthier and more nutritious. And that's how easily a quick breakfast gets ready. Serve it with a side dish of your choice. I enjoyed it with some curry longi and curd. I would highly recommend that you try this recipe and share in the comments how you liked it. The next healthy and protein-rich recipe that I'll share is soya vegetable pancakes. Pre-soak some soya chunks in hot water and keep them aside to fluff up. Next, I'll slit the skin of one tomato and blanch it for 5 minutes. While that is happening, I'll chop some veggies that will go in the pancakes. Feel free to choose veggies of your choice. I'm using whatever is available in the fridge. Blanching tomatoes help in taking the peel off very easily. And now, I'll squeeze excess water from the soya chunks and fine grind it with blanched tomato, green chili, ginger, some curd and salt. Add water if need be to make a pancake batter-like consistency. The batter is ready and the next step is to fine chop the veggies that will go in our vegetable soya pancakes. Chopper just makes life so much easier in the kitchen, as the fine chopping times literally reduces to half. Now add all the chopped veggies in the pancake batter, and for binding, I'll add 3 to 4 teaspoon rice flour. To enhance the taste, add cumin seeds, garam masala, hing, chaat masala, salt, and mix everything well. Adjust the seasonings as per your liking. Today I'll use a deep kadai to make a round shape of these pancakes. You can also use a pan instead. Now make a tempering of oil and mustard seeds and pour the batter. Make sure you spread the batter and don't pour too much batter as it will not cook from the center otherwise. Cook the pancakes covered on low medium heat so that they get crispy from outside and yet remain soft from inside. I'll serve the pancakes with some coconut chutney that I already had. And look how beautiful and appetizing they look. I hope you liked all these recipes. Let me know which one will you surely try in the comment section below. Subscribe to the channel for more such healthy recipes, and I'll see you in my next vlog. Until then, stay tuned and stay connected.